Hey everybody, Brooks for Digital Cloud Training. If you haven't heard or you haven't read or you haven't noticed, something's happening in February that you need to be aware of. And here it is. Jeff Barr wrote an article in July of this year basically stating that if you have public IPv4 addresses associated or unassociated, and that's the big deal, you're going to be charged for them. In fact, if you look at the table, and there it is, it's half a cent per hour. Now, why is that such a big deal? Well, it's basically this. Up until this point, if you've had public IPv4 addresses and they were associated with something, let's say like an EC2 instance or an Amazon workspace, you weren't being charged for them. February 1st and after, you are going to be charged, as Jeff pointed out in this article. So now the thing about that is this. If you start thinking about public IPv4 addresses, they can be all over the place. They could be sitting on an EC2 instance. They could be part of a NAT gateway. They could be in workspaces. It could be RDS. They can be in a lot of places. I even tried to sort of approach the problem of, let's go into the AWS CLI, iterate over some services, and find all the public IPv4 addresses. Didn't really work that well, didn't feel right, and I got a feeling that AWS knew that was going to be a problem as well. So that's why, looking at Jeff's article title, Public IP Insights. It's a new feature of the AWS IP Address Manager console that lets us find these public IPv4 addresses. Let me show you how to use it. From inside the VPC console, go to Search for Services and look for VPC and choose VPC. When that comes up over on the left-hand side here in our menu, scroll all the way to the bottom, and there's VPC IP Address Manager. If you're not familiar with the VPC IP Address Manager, it's a way, particularly if you're using AWS organizations, to monitor and control all your IP addresses. Let me explain that briefly. VPC IP Address Manager, or Amazon IPAM, is just a way of managing your IP addresses. That's really what it all comes down to. It's an IP address manager. It allows you to allocate new addresses and find pre-existing addresses, and that's what we're going to be leveraging. But the biggest part, really, of IPAM is the fact that you can do management. That is, you can set up these pools, particularly private pools, at a top level, and then allow others to use sections or cider blocks of that pool, so that way you've got much better control of your IP addressing. And one of the best features, one of the most sort of understated features, is the fact that it has an historical view. Look, when your cyber team comes to you and says, look, did you use such and such an address? That's where historic view comes in. You can go back and concretely, not this, I think I used a service. No, you can show with historic view either you used it or you didn't use it. And that can really help, particularly your cybersecurity team, when they're doing sort of a retrospect on what may have happened at a particular incident. It also integrates nicely into AWS services like Resource Access Manager and Control Tower. And finally, it is a regional service. So it's not a one and done. You just can't set it up once and you walk away from it. You have to enable it from all the regions. Luckily, when we set up, we can actually do that. But I'm going to give you a bit of caveat on exactly what goes on there. So let's jump over to the console and let's set up a pool in IP Address Manager. Now, before we jump in, I did want to show you something just very quickly, just so you know that I'm on the up and up with this. I've got two boxes up right now. I actually have one up and running and one is turned off. So I've got my public server and my Linux box. But in the case of the public server, notice I do have a public IPv4 address. And hopefully, if everything works right, when we get to IP Insights, we will see that address set up as a public IP address. So switching back to the VPC console, I'm going to go ahead and choose VPC IP Address Manager. Comes up, a lot of great information here at the bottom that you can read about and find out more about how to use it, but we're just going to go right into create an IPAM. Now you'll need to allow the Amazon VPC IP Manager to replicate data, so go ahead and click that on. I'm going to use the free tier. Now the catch with the free tier is that once we go back into the console, things like the dashboard are not going to be available, and I'll show that to you. That you have to use the advanced tier. There are charges for using the advanced tier. I don't really need it in this case. I'm just doing some IP insights, so I'm going to leave it at the free tier. I'm going to give it a global name, global pool. And I'll just name it my IPAM because I just want to do this for demonstration purposes for you. This is where you can set up the regions. And this is my caveat. When you're doing this, you can choose add all regions or go through and start selecting the ones that you want to add in to your pool. Do not add regions you're not using. So for example, let me just jump back. You can see we have Singapore and Sydney. I have no use for those, so I'm not going to enable those. In fact, if all of your assets are like, say, in just US East 1, then just use US East 1. Like you see here, just leave that. It'll work perfectly fine for that. You can go back and enable other regional scopes, but for this one, I'm going to leave it as is. Leave that tag there. Always use good tagging policy. So if this is something where, say, you're going to be using the advanced tier, you want to make sure you want to indicate the cost center by going in and adding a new tag for cost center, whatever the case may be, all done. Let's choose create IPAM. Takes a minute. So here we're back at the panel. And I just want to show you real quick, when I go to dashboard, you can see, in fact, it comes up with upgrade required. And here's that note they're going to give us. There are costs associated with the advanced tier. So this is a great place to sort of go in, find out what the advanced tier is going to give you, and see if you really do need dashboards. In this case, we're just going to be using public IP insights. Let's take a look at that. Ah, and that's exactly what I expected. It takes several minutes for a pool to be set up. So I'm going to let this bubble away, put you on pause, and as soon as this gets done, we'll jump back into the console and see if we can find that public IP address for my EC2 instance. Okay, the pool's finished, public IP insights have run, and now we can see what we have here. So we can actually do a filter if we want to. We have them all turned on at this point, and we do have color coding here, so we can see right off the bat that this one is related to an EC2 public IP. We can check on our accounts, look at public types over time. We can see where they're in. So if you've done something like where you've actually kicked in multiple regions, this is where you can see that breakdown by region, breakdown by account. And then there's that public IP address associated with my EC2 that was I showed you earlier, just to kind of prove this thing really does do exactly what it was intended to do. Probably one of my favorite features of this entire console is this export to CSV that you see right there. With this feature, you're going to be able to kick out a CSV, import it into Excel, any numbers if you're using an Apple laptop or just using the Apple Office sort of software, and actually start looking at those and sending them out to the department saying, hey, it looks like you're responsible for these. It looks like you are responsible for those. That way you can have some accounting. But overall, using the entire console right here really gives us a great view into what we see with the IP addressing. Now, let me state something again. I tried this on my own. I used as much script foo as I could with the AWS CLI. Even tried it with Python, like iterating over services. It was a joke. I didn't even want to try to do it. My point was I needed to find my public IP addresses, and public IP insights does that exact thing. In fact, I'm pretty sure that was the whole motivation behind it, because so many customers were saying, if you're going to do this, you've got to give me a tool where I can find it. And AWS has done exactly that. So you need to turn this feature on. Keep in mind, that was a free tier option. So if you're in the free tier, go ahead and turn on the free tier. You don't need to turn on the advanced to be able to find those public IP addresses. And then once your account is out of the free tier, you have this to be able to go out there and say, oh, I left on that EC2 that I was experimenting with Python so I could learn how to do certain things with it. I forgot that was on. Forgot I gave it a public IP address. Let me go turn it off. And that is the idea behind the IP Insights control panel. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you learned a little bit of how to get in there and figure out how to actually do this. Again, I highly encourage it. And for any of your cloud training, please come visit us over at digitalcloud.training. We have a really awesome library of AWS material that you can look at and some great insights into these services that can really help you out when you go out there in the real world and start using AWS. So until next time, I'm Brooks from DCT. Have a great day.